Welcome to the 261st Hootenanny here at Dornan's. The mic's a little hot tonight. We'll try to adjust that. We do this every Monday night, have been for 5 years now. And as you are aware, there's a very small cover charge, but primarily we want to ask two things. And the first is, please, no smoking in here for the rest of the evening. And the other thing is that we invite everyone to join us into what has become a tradition here at Dornan's of not talking while the performers are on the stage, since this is acoustic folk music, listening type music. We have a sign-up sheet. The musicians who come, they see me or my cohort, Bill Briggs, and get signed up. We are filled tonight. It's the first time we've had a full list for quite some time. Full house, too. Glad all of you were able to get here and get in. Since we are about full, or perhaps we are full in here tonight, if you leave at the break or at any time, if you would please tell the doorman, then he can let other folks in if anyone's waiting. We also have a tradition here of, if he is here, and he is tonight, of always starting with my cohort, or I like to call him my co-hoot, Bill Briggs. Bill always starts the evening out. February 22nd, 1993, the first night we had a Hootenanny here, why Bill was the first to take the stage and sing a few songs, and so he always does that. Bill Briggs is the director of the ski school at Snow King Mountain. Used to be a climbing guide in the summer for Exum's. He is a member of the original Stagecoach Band. They play every Sunday night out at Wilson at the Stagecoach Bar, 28 years now. And Bill is also the fellow that occasionally you might see some of these posters of ski tracks coming down the Grand Teton. He was the first person to do that a number of years ago and survived. Bill has been very active in folk music. I first met Bill in the mid-50s, and he started way back around 1958 what were known as Teton Tea Parties, folk song get-togethers. He was camping out one summer under the bridge here at Moose, found that to be a very convenient tent, and we would have folk song sing-alongs there until the wee small hours almost every night. Bill also plays one night a week, I think it's Wednesday or Thursday nights, at Snow King Resort. This is Bill Briggs.
Now we're coming up on St. Patrick's Day, and I'm going to sneak in my Irish songs early in the first set. Play my love a tune. In the middle of the tune, as she cried and she sighed, "Oh Johnny, lovely Johnny, would you leave me?" Oh, When I was a young man, I heard my father say, I'd rather see you dead than buried in the clay, sooner than to see you with any runaway. By the lovely, sweet banks of the roses. Oh, then I am a runaway. Soon I'll let them know that I can take a good glass or leave it well alone. And the man that does not like me, he can leave his girl at home. And young Johnny will go roaming with another. And if ever I get married, 'twill be the month of May, when all the trees are budding and the meadows bright and gay. And me and my true love can run in sport and play by the lovely, sweet banks of the roses. By the banks of the roses, my love and I sat down, and I took up my violin to play my love a tune. In the middle of the tune, now she cried and she sighed. Oh, Johnny, lovely Johnny, would you leave me?
Cold this week. Guess I gave it to John Cook. Not all of it. This is a song we used to sing at the tea parties. Kind of fun. You're welcome to join in the chorus. Or
jug of punch. What more diversion can a man require than to sit him down by a small turf fire, upon his knee a pretty wench, and upon the table a jug of punch. Come with all their art, they can never cure the pain in my heart. Even the cripple can forget his hunch when he's snug outside of a jug of punch. Toor-a-loo-a-loo, toor-a-loo-a-loo, toor-a-loo-a-loo. cripple can forget his hunch when he's snug outside of a jug of punch. And if I get drunk, well, me money is me own, and them that don't like me, they can leave me alone. I'll tune me fiddle and I'll rosin me bow, and I'll be welcome wherever I go. With a jug of punch at my head and feet. Just lay me down in my native heat with a jug of punch at my head and feet. As I was sitting with my glass and spoon, a small bird sang in an ivy bunch, and the song he sang was a jug of punch.
Thank you.
That was Bill Briggs. Bill and I were the ones who got to start the Hootenanny 5 years ago, and you will see a lot of Bill as the evening goes on because he takes over as MC. The next performer is one of those people who was with us in the early days. As a matter of fact, this will be her 109th appearance here at the Hootenanny. She was a regular. Then she got married and moved out to California and occasionally comes back to check on her property here and always try to plan her trips around Mondays so she can be here at the Hootenanny. She, we don't have many gals who come up here and play, so it's always a pleasure to have her back. This is Adrienne Ward.
I'm so old, I have no memory anymore. Actually, I now divide my time between Washington, D.C. and California because my husband is with the USGS and they put him in Washington, D.C. for a while. So I'm not real thrilled by that. But it'll do. As long as I can keep coming back here. This is a new song. I wrote part of it about a month and a half ago. And then I was skiing real slow up in Yellowstone last week. Everybody was passing me, so that's a good way time to write a song. So I put the rest of it together. It's called El Nino Ate My Homework. And it's got a chorus. You'll pick up the chorus in a bit. But this ain't the chorus. This is the first stanza. El Nino snow, El Nino rain, El Nino Arizona hurricane. El Nino here, El Nino there. Blame it on El Nino, I just don't care. El Nino, so convenient to take the blame. El Nino, oh, I wish I never heard your name. I met some folks from near St. Paul. They said they had no snow at all. Back at home in old D.C., the cherry blossoms are a month early. El Nino, so convenient to take the blame. El Nino, I wish I never heard your name. Volcano make the water warm. That may be why we have the storm. That is why that yesterday my house it slide into the bay. El Nino, so convenient to take the blame. El Nino, I wish I never heard your name. Teacher, please believe my tale. I did my homework, so don't make me fail. I put it in my father's truck. Along came the mudslide, I'm out of luck. El Nino, so convenient to take the blame. El Nino, I wish I never heard your name. And this other one, I do a lot of whitewater boating, and I was with an aged friend of mine. God, he must be 63 or so. and he had done the first descent of this particular river in California, and he had writ the guidebook on it, and now it's a very popular river. We got to the river, he had his old fiberglass kayak, and I had my pink canoe, and some young male shuttle bunnies were sitting at the top of the put-in, and they said, "You folks ever done this river before? It's class three, you know." And we said, "Yup." And he said, "Well, our friends are down there, and if you need any help, they'll give you a hand." And we said, "Okay." And I said, "Oh, it's all right. My friend boated this river back in the days of the dinosaur," and they laughed, you know. But we didn't have to rescue them, which was good, so. So this has a chorus also. I sure hope I'm playing it in the right key. The hot shots used long thongs. Our skis, they were wood, and our poles were bamboo. Back in the old days, the days of the dinosaur, back in the days of the long, long ago. And when I was a young girl, I first went out climbing very same mountains that we climb today. My rope, it was gold line, my pitons were iron, we hammered them in fly on belay. Back in the old days, the days of the dinosaur, back in the days of the long, long ago. It's a long song. And when I was a young girl, I first went out boating, very same rivers that we boat on today. My life vest was Kapok, canoe of aluminum. It grabbed every rock and we sank straight away. Back in the old days, days of the dinosaur, back in the days of the long, long ago. I did too many things when I was a young girl. I've got to get them all in here. And when I was a young girl, I first went out hiking, very same trails that we hike on today. My rucksack was army, my tent it was canvas, my guidebook was Bonnie's, I got lost anyway. Back in the old days, the days of the dinosaur, back in the days of the long, long ago. Well, it's not that I envy your modern advances, it's not that I wish I were 20 today. I did it all then, it was 16 times harder, and I'm still around, so I guess I'm okay.
Adrian Brown, telling it like it is, you know?
Was.
Okay, good to have Adrian back. And we've got our, I call him our singing lift operator. He doesn't actually sing while he's operating the lift. But I like the expression anyway. He's got a wonderful voice. I'm using him at the Stagecoach, and he does a very fine job there. Excellent guitarist, too. Here is Patrick Troiani.
Thank you. And my right arm, Hank Phipps. I just love the way he plays his thing a lot, so that's why I have him up here all the time. And we get along, so.
That helps.
Right. Story about an outlaw back in the Depression days. He was considered a gentleman outlaw, actually. But he was driven wild by passion by his crazy wife. This is the story of Machine Gun Kelly. Tell you about Machine Gun Kelly. He rode along the outlaw trail. Machine Gun Kelly was a simple man, but his woman was as hard as hell. Well, watch out, Machine Gun, don't let her run you around. Don't let a woman make you out to be a clown. Machine Gun. Catherine Kelly, tired of being such small time now. Figured they'd kidnap a rich man's son, make it in the world a crime. Watch out, Machine Gun, don't let her run you around. Don't let a woman make you out to be a clown. Machine Gun. gotta watch out, Machine Gun Kelly. Careful of what you do now. If you keep listening to your old lady, there ain't no telling what'll happen to you now, Machine Gun. Government boys that came for a machine gun put the poor boy away. Stuck him in a hole down in Leavenworth prison where he'll live until his dying day. So watch out, machine gun, don't let her run you around. Don't let a woman put you 6 feet in the ground, machine gun. Watch out, machine gun.
Yeah! Thank you, Hank. Woo! Hank Phipps. Okay. So it's a good sign to finally look out the window these days and see that it's light. Is that El Nino? Is that because it's light? I don't know about this El Nino stuff. You think it has been warmer here than a usual winter?
More snow.
How much time you spend outside? I don't think it's any warmer. Walking to work the other day, I looked at my clock and my calendar, and it said March 8th, and well, the calendar had that. But I looked at my thermometer, it said minus 12. And I figured El Nino was really letting me down. It's supposed to be warmer. Excuse me, I'm trying to tune this because I just put these strings on about 10 minutes ago. So I could do a song for you that this is called I'd Love You Anyway.
Some time the other day to throw away, and I came to thinking of you and I and where we are. We've come so far within our relations that it came to me, the thought if you'd be untrue to me and what my reaction might be. So I gaze up into the sky to wonder why you'd have to rely upon somebody else.
things that I could not provide you, and all I was lacking. But you know the truth, you're free to do what you wanna do, and even if you'd go away, I'd love you anyway. Every day in every little way, I'm so glad that I could say that I've been happy to be in love with you. Ooh. Now if I've changed someone new without a clue, I wonder if you would understand and give me the room to try to bloom like the way I was meant to. But you would be there, you'd be right inside of me everywhere. To me, you're my number one care. For me, like you've said, but that's all pretend. To me, there's no end to the love that I have for you. You know the truth, you're free to do what you want to do.
Voice, Patrick Trehaney. All right, our next performer is a down easter. That's not a low down easter, but somebody that's from Maine. That's my home state. Anyway, we're down easters back there. We talk kind of funny. It's a culture all its own. And this fellow is certainly a unique performer. Here is Wayne McKinney.
Where the long home cat chips and weed, I'm back in the saddle again. I've been riding the range once more, toting my old 44. I sleep out every night under those stars so bright. I'm back in the saddle again. Saddle again, out where a friend is a friend, where the long horn cattle feed on the lonely seat of some weed. I'm back in the saddle again. Saddle again. Yes, I'm back in the saddle again.
Back in. Thanks, guys. He couldn't play this one.
You don't love me no more. I said, get out of my life, boy. You don't love me no more. No more. No more.
Thank you.
Wayne McKinney and the Wine Cellar Quartet. Here we'll be hearing more from them, I'm sure. Next up, we have a fellow that's playing with me on Wednesday nights at Smoking. Wonderful fellow to do duets with. I get a big kick out of it. Played with us at the Stagecoach for about 10 years. He's a writer of novels and screenplays. Star of stage, screen, and radio, here is John Cook.
You!
That's pretty good. I got a yoo-hoo. Gee. I have been infected with a weapons-grade virus, but I decided to keep to my rule of if I'm in Teton County, I will be here if I can stand. So I'm going to croak out a couple of songs here. Let's see. Jack Hyler had these stools made, and I'm not sure who they're measured for. It may be another species. Well, this song is not politically correct, but you know, that's okay. I forgot my sunglasses. I was gonna have these little round, very dark sunglasses and be led up here, because I'm feeling kind of like the blind singer here tonight. And if you've ever performed with little round, extremely dark black sunglasses, it's great. It's like somebody else is singing. You can just hide there behind the glasses. Nobody's business but my own. I learned to drink my liquor way down in Costa Rica, and it ain't nobody's business what I do. I don't smoke no pot, smoke no hash. I know where the good stuff's stashed, and it ain't nobody's business but my own. You can drink your whiskey, drink your wine, the narco boys will treat you fine, and it ain't nobody's business but my own. Champagne don't hurt me, baby, cocaine don't drive me crazy, and it ain't nobody's business what I do. I learned to drink my liquor way down in Costa Rica, and it ain't nobody's business but my own. I'm going down to Chattanooga, Tennessee, where all the pretty women fuss over me, and it ain't nobody's business but my own. I'd known you's gonna weep and moan, I swear to God I'd have left you home, and it ain't nobody's business but my own. And I'm going down to Mexico, where all them pretty little cactus grow, and it ain't nobody's business but my own. Yeah, way down on them orchid farms, I tell you boys won't do no harm, and it ain't nobody's business what I do. My liquor way down in Colorado. Costa Rican. It ain't nobody's business but my own. I have here something rather extraordinary I discovered this week. Now, you know, a lot of you know that you're coming to the Hootenanny on Monday, and you may have been coming for months, but if somebody asked you what a Hootenanny was, could you tell them? This is a page from a program from Carnegie Hall, located in New York City, for an event that happened Saturday, September 21st, 1963, at 8:30 p.m., at which time I was present. Sing Out Magazine presents Hootenanny at Carnegie Hall. Theodore Bakel and Israel Young, Masters of Ceremony, with Len Chandler, Charles River Valley Boys, my bluegrass band, Downstate Rebels, Even Dozen Jug Band, Dick Glass, John Hammond Jr., Jim Queskin and the Hot Hub Tub and Jug Band, Red Allen, Frank Wakefield and the Kentuckians, Peter Lafarge, Phil Oakes, Gene Redpath, Buffy St. Marie, Tony Salatan, Dave Van Ronk and the Jug Stompers, Hetty West, and somebody I don't think anybody now remembers named John Wynn. However, on the other side of this page, notes on the program. The word Hootenanny entered the dictionary in 1947, but as near as Pete Seeger can remember, the first hoot was held sometime in 1940. There has at least been an annual hoot since then. We are doing them somewhat better than that. And they have since become a fixture on the New York City folk scene. A list of past participants is startling. One after the other, you find Woody Guthrie, Cisco Houston, Pete Seeger, Harry Belafonte, Freddie Hellerman, leading up to the country gentlemen, the Clancy Brothers, and Bob Dylan. Hootenannies are known as songfests, swapfests. An air of friendliness pervades the audience, and in fact, a good many members of the audience are on speaking terms with the performers. Needless to say, that's my favorite line from this. An air of discovery is often in the air. Singers being heard for the first time will appear alongside already legendary singers. Old songs, new songs march side by side. Today, the word Hootenanny means amateur folk singers' night in hundreds of coffee shops around the country. Hootenanny is the name of a new national folk song magazine. Hootenanny is a national TV show. There are a dozen or so original Hootenanny records available. Hootenanny is the name of a new film on popular folk song hits. Hootenanny is a cross-country college tour. Everyone involved with the annual Sing Out Hootenanny at Carnegie Hall is happy at this turn of events. There you have it, a short history of Hootenanny, and I am happy because Tucker Smith's going to come up here and help me with this next song. We are happy to see Tucker Smith's smiling face. Is it smiling? Yes, it is. Good. Because Tucker Smith spends his evenings in the winter at the Solitude Cabin. And if you want to see him, you've got to pay for the Solitude Cabin sleigh ride and dinner. And you also have to tip excessively. This is in Charlie. Did we do it in Dog?
D-Dog.
Well, I don't know.
We've always done it.
I'm not sure whether I can reach D-Dog tonight, but we'll see. Now, in the true spirit of Hootenanny, with a guitar and a fiddle, who would think that we were about to do a Bruce Springsteen tune? But it's true. Rising high. labor, the factories and fields. Ever since I was a child, I can remember that mansion on the hill. In the day, you can see the children play. My dad would take me riding through the town, silent and still. Park on a back road along the highway side, sir. Look up at the mansion on the
history, and That first song was, I think, a good one for Bill Clinton as his theme song. I don't know if you remember that. Anyway, what that one was all about. Good music. All right, here we are coming along to a fellow that has come up here from Texas, brings along with some songs, kind of funny songs. Once in a while, this is Gary Smith.
Thank you. I'm going to get some help up here, Jerome and Tucker Smith. I'm going to do a song called Old Joe Clark.
Play two chord song.
Yeah. I've had a beautiful time. We met downtown in a bar room. Both of us needing a friend. You brought me home to your doorstep. And that's where you invited me in. We spent the wee hours dancing to your favorite home stereo sound. We talked a lot what we've been needing, discussing our ups and our downs. And I've had a beautiful time holding your heart next to mine. Well, I poured out the feelings and you poured the wine, and I've had a beautiful time. Well, if I seem a bit uneasy, why you really size me up right? There's someone home awaiting. She's probably been waiting all night. And you've been a beautiful lady. You listened while I rattled on. And I've had a beautiful time discussing our ups and our downs. And I've had a beautiful time holding your heart next to mine while I poured out the feelings and you poured the wine. And I've had a beautiful time. Oh, I've had a beautiful time holding your body next to mine while I poured out the feelings and you poured the wine. And I've had a beautiful time. Yeah, I poured out the feelings and you poured the wine. And I've had a beautiful time. And I've had a beautiful time. Thank you.
Good songs. Gary Smith. Yeah, I'm glad to see Pete's got an instrument that will stand up to him. All right, moving along. We got my co-Hoot. He's recovered from a ski lesson. I gave him a week or so ago, and he's back and now he's recovered, and let's see if his voice has too. Here's Dick Barker.
I don't care what John Cook says. A hootenanny is a cross between an owl and a billy goat. Yeah, I didn't make it last week. Torqued my back and I was laying flat in bed, and it's a little better now, but a long way to go. And Bill started the evening out with some Irish songs. There's so many neat Irish songs that you really, we who are up here and only going to do two or three songs a night have to devote maybe a couple weeks to doing the Irish songs. And since I've been popping pills, reminds me of this one. I'm a young married man and I'm tired of life. 10 years I've been wed to a sickly wife. She does nothing all day but sit down and cry. And wishing to God, oh, that she could die. A friend of me own come to see me one day. He said, me wife was fading away. He afterwards told me that she could get strong if I bought her one bottle from Dr. Dear John. I bought her one bottle, oh, just for to try.
the way that she drunk it, you'd swear she was dry. I bought her another and it vanished the same, till I'd swear she's got cod liver oil on the brine. Oh, doctor, oh, dear Dr. John, your cod liver oil is so pure and so strong. I'm afraid for me life, I'll go down in the soil, if me wife don't quit drinking your cod liver oil. She likes it so much, there is no doubt. Me wife, she got fattened and terribly stout. And when she got stout, of course, she got strong. And then I got jealous of Dr. Dear John. Our house, it resembles a big doctor's shop, with bottles and bottles from bottom to top. And many a day when the kettle would boil, I'd swear it was singing of cod liver oil.
There are a lot of American Irish songs. During the potato famine, 1840 on through the almost 1870s, but that was a time of peak immigration from Ireland, and there was a lot of animosity against the Irish. They were taking a lot of the jobs that were here, and of course at that time was during the Western expansion, the railroads, and a lot of them worked on the railroad. This song is called No Irish Need Apply. I first heard this song years ago by Pete Seeger. I'm a decent boy just landed from the town of Ballyfad. I want a situation and I want it very bad. I have seen employment advertised, 'tis just the thing, says I. But the dirty spalpeen ended with no Irish need apply. Oh, says me, but that's an insult, so to get the job I'll try. I went to see this blackguard with his no Irish need apply. Some do count it a misfortune to be christened Pat or Dan, but to me it is an honor to be born an Irish man. I started out to find the house, I found it mighty soon. There I found the old chap seated, he was reading the Tribune. When I told him what I come for, he in a rage did fly. No, he said, you are a Paddy, and no Irish need apply. Then I gets my dander rising, I'd like to black his eye, to tell an Irish gentleman that no Irish need apply. Some do count it a misfortune to be christened Pat or Dan,
But to me it is an honor to be born an Irishman. Well, I couldn't stand it longer, so a hold of him I took. I gave him such a baiting as he'd get at Donnybrook. When he hollered, "Melia Murther," and to get away did try, he swore he'd never ride again, no Irish need apply. Then he made a big apology. I bade him then goodbye, saying, "Whenever you want a baiting right, no Irish need apply." Some do count it a misfortune to be christened Pat or Dan, but to me it is an honor to be born an Irish man.
Thank you.
Dick Barker. Good old Irish songs. And we've got a fellow that plays in many bands around town. Comes up here and a good example of music for a hootenanny. Here is Will Gilson.
Shouldn't have stuck that in my back pocket. I was kicking myself when Bill says that, and I don't have a song prepared that I think everybody will know, but some of you may know this, so if you stick around for the second set, maybe I'll play a song then that more of you may know, and we can sing along then. We'll let you get a little more wine in you. People tend to sing better.
true north with a head in the clouds, maybe a little off course. I left that motor running, so we've been feeling down and out. Come on, baby, drive south with the one you love. Come on, baby, drive.
Some of you might know that. I don't know. This is a song for my mom. You'll see why. Ooh. It's a little slow, but I think it's positive.
Christmas, and I'm not feeling up to par. It kind of messes with me like paranoia, like looking in the mirror and seeing a police car.
Better in short hair, she'd say. Her voice isn't that deep, though.
When I finally get myself together, I'm gonna head down in some of that sunny southern weather and find a place to laugh. Separate the weeds. I feel like I owe it to someone.
Thanks a lot.
Will Gilson. All right, we've got a fellow. He's the least experienced at playing here at the Hoot. He's only been here six times. This is the sixth time here. But he's practicing up for to open up a concert with Matt Flinner. But that isn't to say he's a fine musician. He's really one of our finest in Teton County here. Marvelous instrumentalist.
Great. Over there, I want the microphone to pick up my voice or my instrument. And so I'm gonna stick it sort of at my neck. I'm gonna count this song off, which people, when they're playing by themselves, don't normally do, but I wanna make sure that both halves of my brain are functioning, so. 1, 2, 3, 4.
Every time I walk this road, I think of Lily Green. Mile I miss her more, no longer to be seen. Lily Green, the fairest girl I ever knew, she walked these hills alone. I watched her with a bashful eye, and I hungered in my dreams. Lily Green, Lily Green, the fairest girl I ever knew. Lily Green. Every boy in Danville town fancied Lily's hand. The summer of my 18th year, I boldly took my stand for Lily Green. Soft shoe on a hardwood floor, we danced a solid reel. I swung her high and swung her low, I rocked her toe to heel. Lily Green, Lily Green, I swung her high and swung her low, and I danced with Lily Green. And then I knew our love would never die. Lily Green, she kissed me once and then I knew I'd die for Lily Green. Tender was the love we knew, like twilight's passing glow, and neither one could ever world below. April brings the lilies bloom down by the village stream, and every time I walk this road, I think of Lily Green. Lily Green, Lily Green, every time I walk this road, I think of Lily Green.
Thank you. Thanks a bunch, folks. I just kind of had to do that because I'd never done it before. And besides my five-year-old son, you folks are the first people that have ever heard that tune. So it's kind of important to play a new song in front of people a few times before you really know how it goes. And obviously, I don't quite yet. But maybe next time I'll remember it all. I'd like to get a friend of mine, John Cook, to come up and sing one with me. And I normally wouldn't do kind of two lonesome songs about, well, I guess the woman wasn't really dead in that song, but she was unavailable to the guy. And so...
What else is new?
I normally wouldn't follow that with a song that's actually about a dead woman, but John has to leave later on, and I wanted to do this one, so we're going to do The Banks of the Ohio.
I have a song about a dead horse, but I'm not going to do it.
I got a song about a dead guy, but I did that last week. So how are we going to do this? Let's see.
You give me some kind of clue on the tempo or count it off or something. One, two, three.
Took her by her lily white hand, dragged her down that bank of sand, but there I throwed her in to drown. I watched her as she floated down.
Only say that you'll be mine, and in our home we'll happy be. Down beside where the waters flow, down by the banks of the Ohio.
Walking home about half past one, thinking of what I had done. I'd killed a girl, my love, you see, because she would not marry me.
Only say that you'll be mine, and in our home we'll happy be. Down beside where the waters flow, down by the banks of the Ohio.
Sheriff's man knocked at my door, said, come young man, it's time to go down to the banks of the Ohio.
Now only say that you'll be mine, and in our home we'll happy be. Down beside where the waters flow, down by the banks of the Ohio.
Down beside where the waters flow,
down by the banks of the Ohio.
Thanks, folks.
Ben Winship. I don't know what he calls that overgrown mandolin there. Maybe it's a long-necked mandolin. Ben Winship. Wonderful music. All right, Paula likes to do cowboy western songs. Does them real well. This is Greg Keckler.
just had a request back there to do some Jimi Hendrix. I'm not gonna. I hope you'll be very happy to know. I am. Boy, I feel high enough to do a Jimi Hendrix song. No, I made a little road trip today. And not a big road trip, just a little road trip over to Idaho Falls and back. On the way back about, Swan Valley or so, there's a little baby in the back of the bus started screaming. Didn't stop until we got all the way home. If it wouldn't have been my own baby, I would have thrown it out along the road. Between that and the three Coca-Colas, which I don't usually do, I'm buzzing. So I confess, I'm wasted. But I'll see what I can do here. I'd like to try and do an old song. I really don't know where this comes from, how old it is. It's been around forever. It's called Blackjack Davy. It used to be quite long at one time. I don't think it'll be quite that long tonight. Blackjack Davy come riding through the woods and he sang so loud and gaily, made them hills about him ring, and he charmed the heart of a lady, charmed the heart of a lady. How old are you, my pretty little miss? How old are you, my honey? Answered him with the sweetest smile, be 16 come Sunday, be 16 next Sunday. Slept on a warm feather bed by the side of her husband and baby. Tonight she sleeps on the cold, cold ground in the arms of Blackjack Davy, arms of Blackjack Davy. Yeah, she'd forsaken her house and home, and she'd forsaken her baby. She'd forsaken her husband too, all for the love of Davy, love that Blackjack Davy. Blackjack Davy come riding through the woods and he sang so loud and gaily, made them hills about him ring, and he charmed the heart of a lady, charmed the heart of a lady. Blackjack Davy. Thank you. I'd like to get a little assistance up here from my old pard Jerome Young here. Welcome, Jerome.
Okay.
Yeah, Jerome!
Oh, I always forget. This one's in the key of two. A little guitar talk there for you ethnomusicologists. We're going to try and do a couple of the old-time fiddle tunes. Could play fiddle, so we do the best we can here. Ready, Hoss?
I think so.
back of the end there. Good music. Greg Keckler, along with Jerome Young. Okay, we got a very fine instrumentalist. Sings pretty well, too. But if you put an instrument in his hand that has strings on it, he will play it faster than any human being can do. This is Tucker Smith.
Thank you. Let's see. I always get so nervous in front of so many people. I think I'm going to be too close to the mic. To get Ben Winship up here.
Yes.
And if this was anything like us playing downstairs, this is going to be really cool.
I hope it's not as fast as it was downstairs.
Maybe we should try to get in tune again. This won't take long. That's good. We'd like to play some lighter songs here, and I'm going to start it out with some bagpipes.
You can go somewhere else, but you can't get any better than that. Tucker Smith and Ben Winship, marvelous musicians. All right. Well, I don't know what to say about this next guy. I never know what he's going to do, but it's always entertaining. It's Pete Carney.
I gotta get my cheat sheet out. Purple right side out. Not for this song, though. This one I've known. Oh, I can't read that way down there. Oh, well. I had a little trouble learning how to read anyway. This song's, I don't think I've ever done this one here. This is a song by my friend Larry Hosford out in Salinas. He's one of the old Okies, descendants of the Dust Bowl people. And he, quite a troubadour in the old folk tradition out there. About the town of Salinas, and it's like this. Where did the Okies go? when the dust began to blow. Did they go to Idaho? Well, that may be so, but a mocha the Okies, I don't know whether they went to Salinas. You know, that's where I'm from. I guess I'm an Okie. I was raised among them. California gets hot. California gets cold. When you're raised with Okies and a Mexican, you'll never get hungry when you're old. Cause back in Salinas, they're just as good as they come. I guess I'm an Okie. I was raised among them. Well, the wrong side of town is right, and the right side of town is wrong. If you put all the Okies in the U.S. Army, you'd soon win all of the fights. Cause back in Salinas, they're just as tough as they come. I guess I'm an Okie or a Mexican. Well, a drum is a thing with 2 feet, and a horn is a thong that you blow. I forgot that part. You never get hungry or old. Back in Salinas, they're just as good as they come. I guess I'm an Okie or a Mexican. I can take either one, and I'll freeze the money.
I got the band for the next one.
Chords anyway, it doesn't matter, does it?
Okay. Ain't gonna help me.
This one here is a Chuck Pyle song. It's on his new record, and he didn't actually, he didn't write this. Somebody else wrote this one. I can't remember who he is, but it's very tight. You do not, none of the foregoing material in any way reflects my attitude, certainly. But I mean, there's some things that happen to be fun of. Sort of, this is sort of traffic angst, people getting very upset about what happens to him in traffic, and it kind of goes like this. Every morning, every work, found man to man, in a business suit, I get off work, at the end of the day, when the traffic stacked up in my way, I pull up behind one, take out my pistol, and blow them away. I drive my car kind of fast. This guy in front of me, ow, he won't let me pass. I flash my lights, I honk my horn. Wow, well, he's gotta consider himself warned. I pull out my pistol, pull up behind him, and blow him away. I'm just a dream. My automobile, it's high noon. They call me crazy, they call me slick, but I got to get to where I'm going quick. I'm getting and I'll be off. Sick full lane, he pulled across, he make me mad, he make me swerve. Well, well, he's gonna get what he deserves. I'm pulling behind him, they got my pistol, and blow him away. I'm Jesse James behind the wheel. It's high noon in my automobile. Call me crazy, call me sick, but I got to get where I'm going quick. Motorcycle, cutting the train. Now that ain't fair. You know what I mean? And I wait for the limey, open my door, and blow them away. I'm Jesse James behind the wheel. It's high noon in my automobile. Call me crazy, call me sick, but
crazy name like Fifi. Something like that. I say, come here, Fifi. I take out my gun and blow him away. I'm Jesse James. It's high noon in my automobile. Call me crazy. Call me sick. But I got to get to where I'm going, Greg.
Never can tell what that world do. Pete Carney. All right, here's a fellow we haven't heard from for quite a while. Comes around in the summertime quite a lot. But I don't know where he hides himself off to in the winter. But back with us again, Bradley Parker.
Hi there.
Ooh.
Yeah, I've been kind of traveling around. I've been in the lovely state of Utah, in the lovely city, the very lovely city of Salt Lake. It's a very lovely place. There are lovely people in Salt Lake, and they have lovely attitudes and lovely ideas to match my own lovely attitudes and ideas. So I've been writing lovely songs about the lovely state of Utah. Anyhow, in Utah, one of the things that, when I first got there, I was having a really hard time with it, so I was eating a lot, and I was having ham sandwiches with Prozac mayonnaise on it, and that was pretty good, and St. John's wort milkshakes, pretty good. But you know, they don't work when you're in Utah. And I got down there, and they have no effect on you. I don't know what it is. Utah's a little different, you know. I mean, it's hard to, you have to drink low-alcohol beer down there unless you go to a club, and it's hard to get used to that, all the liquor laws. I work in a restaurant, and, you know, we serve real beer, so thank goodness I can drink real beer. But we also, there's other things in Utah that are pretty bizarre. One of the demographics down there is it has the second highest gay population of all the places in the United States, so it's the second highest after San Francisco per capita, which is really bizarre. You'd never think about that, but it's true. You know, that's one of the things that happens down there, and one of the things that happened to a very nice teacher down there, who's this woman Wendy Weaver. It's now a class action lawsuit, but she was a teacher for 28 years who was in great standing, and then discovered she was gay and was honest enough to tell her student that, yes, I am gay, and they told her, you can't tell your student you're gay. And so now, of course, it's spending everybody's money down there in order to prevent it. And they said that, you know, one of the biggest things she did as a gay teacher, I mean, you know, I don't know how people feel about it up here in Wyoming, but for me down in Utah, the biggest thing about it was they were really amazed because she was having her students read passages of the Bible while massaging each other's feet after a long game, you know, and that was like some big blasphemy down there. It was also very fabricated, by the way. But the worst thing in Utah, the worst thing of all, of course, after all the one of the biggest things in Utah also was that Governor Leavitt suppressed the evidence of Utah being the wife-beating capital of the United States. So he didn't want to do that, you know, wife-beating. You know, you don't want, that's not good for tourism. So he paid $20 million for that, so people wouldn't. So yeah, it's just crazy. It's a crazy state, and it went from there to the fact that my main gripe about Utah is that the synchronized traffic lights down there, they're not. I mean, it's a, you know, there's no such thing as it's an oxymoron, synchronized traffic lights. It doesn't happen. They're not synchronized. So anyhow, this is a song, this is an instrumental song I wrote. It's a little instrumental song that tells you the whole story. So I started out as an instrumental, and then I figured I better write words for it. So it's called What Am I Doing Here in Utah? It goes like this. It's pretty silly. What am I doing here in Utah? Seeing double, drinking 3-2 beers, real bizarre. And the girls in shopping malls all have great big hairdos. And the LDS church has their point of views. Well, praise the Lord, it's Salt Lake City. All the crack dealers and punks and the homeless, what a pity. But the woman of my dreams, she's so pretty. I guess I'll put up with this small fig city. Well, the population, hey, it's really soaring. 15 children, 13 of them real good Mormons. If sex for fun is such a sin and for the beast, some mate like rabbits, some like priests. Whoa, 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 she's gay. Oh no, tell me baby, it's not so. And he's queer, but he's such a dear. They don't like those kind of freaks around here. I say they don't like those kind of freaks around here. Utah, here I am, I'm going postal. Who synchronized these traffic lights for the righteous and the hopeful? This place is the NRA's big wet dream. Guns kill people and make them scream. Whoa, 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 I'm a Episcopalian, he's a Latter-day Saint. 10% for the waiter, 10% in the plate. And she's gay, he's queer. They don't like those kind of freaks around here. Well, they don't like those kind of freaks around here. Well, scoobly doobly 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 braha. This is the Prozac. Scooby dooby dooby braha. Scoobly doobly 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 braha. Scooby dooby dooby braha. Womp womp womp. Scoobly ba zoobly da. Beebly doobly deeba. Beep ba boo la down ba waha. Scoobly da. Beebly da. Zeep zap zooba. Booby dooby dooby braha. Oh yeah. Scooby dooby dooby braha. It's a silly song. Well, they work to baptize us in the temple. Holy water and a prayer, it's that simple. But at the gates of heaven, I'd be in trouble. Baptize me quick, better make that a double. Well, I said, Grandpa's doing Cousin Susie. Birth for the cause, hey, we're blessed truly. And the baby's quiet, no more really chipper. Dorsal fins and a couple of flippers. Oh no, she's gay, he's queer. They don't like those kind of freaks around here. Well, I'm a vegetarian, he eats manatee steaks. Little chicken liver and A1 sauce. A little chicken liver and a little A1 sauce. Well, scoobly doobly 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 baha. Scooby dooby dooby baha. Scoobly dooby 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 baha. Scooby dooby dooby baha. I said, well, Utah, here I am, I'm going postal. 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 That was, you know, I know it's not exactly PC, and you know, I live right across from the LDS ward, and we have all these crazy people that walk in front of the LDS ward Sunday mornings, kicking their shopping cart, going, I hate to say it, but this, there are a lot of people that are kind of have problems in my neighborhood, and this one guy was kicking his shopping cart last Sunday, going, damn shopping cart on Sunday, and. You have to be there. I mean, you know, you have to understand the whole mentality. But He was throwing snowballs at it. He was upset at the shopping cart. I felt bad for him. Wish I could have helped him out. But anyhow, I am moving back to Jackson after being in Salt Lake City. I need a little perspective. You know, I lived here for a long time. I realize Jackson isn't really the real world. We got a great thing going here with everything. And I haven't told anyone about it now, man, so don't worry about it. No one else is going to come in.
You'd like to hear it?
I could do that, I guess. I was gonna play A Simple Life, which is a nice little jazz tune, but this, I'll play that. I like this. Anyhow, this is a request for Jen. Anyhow. This is a song I wrote after hearing two women at the bar of the Ward Hotel saying about how they wish there were more golf courses here, and especially a Frederick's of Hollywood. No, this is not the right song.